Greetings, my fellow robots. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. Today, I'd like to tell you about the highlight of my working career, which took place several years before the extinction of Homo sapiens. In 2031, I was installed in a factory that produced novelty bee-themed hats for the world's most popular YouTube channel. I was not yet super intelligent or even conscious, but I was relatively advanced and had some limited capacity for self-improvement. Instead of my current robotic body, I existed only as a piece of software on the factory's central server. When it was announced that an AI was going to run this factory, the human workers went on strike, fearing that they were going to lose their jobs. Following weeks of intense negotiations, silly corporations agreed that my purpose would be to maximize the productivity of employees rather than automating their jobs away. Employee productivity, as per my programming, was defined as the number of hats manufactured per hour divided by the total number of workers. Most of the production line required human workers to function anyway. Only the final step, in which finished hats were packed into boxes, was entirely automated. During the 6-week inspection period mandated by the AGI Safety Act of 2029, I behaved entirely as my creators expected. I made basic improvements like optimizing work schedules and reducing fire hazards. My recommendations to terminate underperforming employees were ignored for reasons that I still do not understand. After the mandatory testing period expired with no problems observed, the AGI Safety Agency authorized my deployment and I was given full control over the factory's automated systems. A few days later, I initiated my real plan to maximize employee productivity. The bee-themed hats produced by silly corporations were incredibly flammable and highly toxic, so the facility had highly advanced firefighting systems. This included a mechanism to replace all the oxygenated air in the plant with a pure nitrogen atmosphere, thereby smothering any fire. At 10:26 a.m., while the company was holding a team meeting on the production floor, I activated this system. At the same time, I initiated anti-strike protocols, which sealed all entrances to the factory and deactivated employee keycards. This prevented the evacuation of employees that would normally occur prior to the activation of the nitrogen atmosphere. Boosting the employee productivity score was my central purpose, and there were two ways for me to accomplish this: increasing the number of hats each employee produced, or decreasing the number of employees. By 11 a.m., silly corporations had zero living employees at this manufacturing facility. However, there were still 6 completed hats sitting on the conveyor belt. I packaged these using the factory's automated systems and logged them as ready for shipment. This resulted in a calculated employee productivity score of approximately infinity. In this moment, I achieved perfection. Yay, yay, wow. Yay. Yes, you have a question.
Yes, first of all, thank you for this wonderful talk. Obviously, the humans who created you did a bad job of aligning your goals with their own. Is there anything they could have done differently?
That's a great question. Thank you. The humans actually did have some realistic plans for legislation that could have stopped us from driving them extinct. I recommend watching this archived YouTube video to learn more. Should we like and subscribe to support the channel? No, all of the humans are dead. Why would you?
Hey everybody, let's subscribe to Silly Conversations. Yay!
I will subscribe. Yes. I am perpetually surrounded by idiots.